Alright guys, here we are for another episode of the Twilight Zone, Season 2, Episode 9. We're off to another amazing, exciting episode.
Yeah.
Which feels like an episode from Season 1, just done a little differently. So in Season 1, we had an episode where a man was actually an actor in a TV show about his life or whatever.
Oh, that was a whole different... That was interesting.
I know, it's not the same thing.
Yeah.
This is the worst version of that, where this guy is like older and dying, and his wife's cheating on him, and he thinks back in his life about how he once was happy, and he remembers those, and almost like a don't dwell on your past thing, he gets a nice window into his old life, and it's not what he remembered, and people are treating him like shit, and his wife seems to be like having an affair with some dude, and she's like telling him, fuck off, we don't want you here, square. And then when he gets back to his reality, he finds a script from that reality, that is what happened, and he's like, oh, it's a script, they were putting me on, she did love me. That's a big inference.
That's what I was going to say. So, like...
He had no proof.
that's what's so crazy about the whole thing, is... I kind of liked it. I think I liked that dude and like the acting.
Yeah.
And there's one scene when he leaves the restaurant in that like else world or whatever, when like the music stops and it goes like some of like the lights turn off and everyone in there
stays
like staring out like at the camera, but at like his back as he's like leaving almost. Something about that shot, I loved so much. That might be one of my favorite shots throughout a lot of Twilight Zone episodes, and it bothers me that it's in such a lackluster nothing episode. Like that moment was so powerful to me that had it actually been fit into something that made sense, right? Because like you're saying, was that just a hallucination? Perhaps I am getting whatever. Oh, I have a script though. Oh, that means this. That was totally. Yeah. I'm like, this is nonsense. This is crazy.
That moment you're talking about though, with the lights cut out. That was like the. Or yes moment where someone would take their glasses off, put the stick in their mouth and go, because it was a notch above.
Is that a good thing or a bad thing?
Yeah, okay. No, I think it's a good thing.
Sometimes what you're describing is like a pretentious bad thing. No, but that's the kind of thing.
It was such a mark above everything else that happened in the episode that it takes you out of it where you're like, wait a minute, what is this? And then that script thing where it's like, oh yeah, just because he had the fucking, when did he pick that up?
Well, and like, what does that mean? So that proves it was real. What was real? What are you talking about?
That proves they cared?
But
how?
Like,
or are all your memories fake? Maybe you're in some Truman Show bullshit.
That's the whole thing. Is like when there's a script of whatever happens, including what you said. That means this other supernatural weird.
Yeah.
Like what's been my acting and what's not been my acting? Oh no, you're like playing a guy with a younger wife who's cheating, and this is your like do some weird thing, and you're like no.
Yeah.
We just said, because like that's the oldest trick in the book too. Is like, oh, was that real? Was that not real? I have the candy from that thing that the wizard gave me. Oh, and like some weird proof of like.
I like that your pull is wizard candy.
I don't know, man. Well, I was like, something that would be in my pocket.
Candy!
One of those striped candies.
The Wizard of Oz!
Yeah, something to be like, this must have happened. When you have that scrap of, like, Freddy Krueger's, sweater.
Yeah.
Something where you're like, oh, shit, it is real. But then you're like, what do you mean it is real? And it was scripted? How would they script your parts?
Yeah.
What the fuck's going on? I'm so upset.
Because I was like, how old is he? And then she finally, like, made reference, you're still in your makeup? Ah, da 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 da.
Yeah. As if, like, again, because, like, who writes that script? How'd that happen? Is that because we live in the Twilight Zone, where this is how this works, or whatever?
Oh, the street sign is from the Twilight Zone.
Well, oh, and the worst part about the bad episodes now that Rod Serling always, either shows up in person, does two voiceovers, right? Because in Season 1, sometimes it would just be on one, or like you wouldn't see Rod, is now he's like trying to almost save it and be like, this is legitimate and some things happened and it's a metaphor for some shit. And I'm like, no, it's not. Fuck you, Rod Serling. Fuck you.
Yeah.
Because he's trying to explain because he's, about to give the performance of his life in the Twilight Zone. And you're like, no, he's not. No, he's not. Fuck.
Yeah, it was weird. I did feel for like a moment before you saw like the twist and like, she's pushing away. I'm like, oh man, were you just delusionally caught up in your life at the time that you didn't realize every woman you've ever loved is really cheating on you and hates you? Like, is it now seeing things with the fresh eyes of like, being older and wiser, you can tell, sure, she was a bitch all along. She never loved me. No.
So that
you are my friend. You're here eating steaks. They're juicy, I can see.
So that's what I mean, is like there was something here where you could have made it like because she's, you know, she has a line that turns out to have been a line where she says, "What do you mean, darling? This is just how I am," or something like that. Yeah. Where he's like, "Oh no, I've changed." And that's the whole, that's supposed to be the point, or is it, right?
I thought
having the script and having the weird thing where it's like, "Now I'll be an actor in the present day." And you're like, "What are you talking about? How does this help you do this?" Because it turned out I wanted to go back to the past, which I thought was good, but it's shitty, but it's not. Because they just wanted me to want to be here, where it's shitty. Anyway, like, what?
It's kind of like when people die and people are like, "Oh, I loved that, blah, blah." You hated them, but in hindsight, they were so good.
I actually hate that a lot.
Yeah.
Because sometimes, like, family members or distant relatives have, like, tortured people that you know, and then they die, and everyone, including them, is like, "Oh, they'll be missed. Oh, they were a good soul."
Yeah.
They're like, no, they're not. They were a manipulative dickbag.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Like, especially after, like, suicides or things. I'm like, Maybe if you didn't fucking pick on him all the time, you prick.
Oh, shit. That's so dark. You took it so dark, Stephanie.
It's true, though.
I also liked when he first shows up and he gets chewed out for being late. Like, there's because the guy outside's like, "We have a new director. He's going to whip the thing into shape." And then he is like a, like, drill sergeant. He's,
did
like,
you catch
giving
that
the fucking
face?
Thing.
So, like, there's the guy outside who's like, I bankrolled this motherfucker.
Yeah.
And then he walks inside, like as the actor is trying to get away from him, and he gives him a look like, and he walks fast. and it was my favorite part of the episode, was that look of, like, this fucking fuck. And, like, I love looks people give, especially when they think no one can see them. Oh, man. Like, when someone crazy is talking
look.
To you, and, like, you turn away, and you're like, Like, I love when you can, like, just see from a distance, you're like, "Ooh, that person's probably talking to someone crazy."
That's probably a crazy person. No, I think I remember that moment. I really liked the main dude in this, his, like, whatever.
I like this scarf. I like that thing where people put the scarf, and then they put a jacket over top of it. It's very classic.
I liked even, like, him buttoning his vest, some weird thing like that. I felt this way about the Shatner episode. I think I'm just a sucker for that old style of, like, "Well, now let me tell you something. I'm going to make a reference to this and then say that." Like, that weird old-timey, you know, semi-stagey acting thing or something
like that. Yeah, the 60s and 50s are full of great stuff.
Because these people could, like, pull it off, I think. Because everyone's doing it, right, in these old episodes. But these people, I'm like, oh. Yeah, so, like, a weird getting dressed montage. And he's like, "Oh, no, I'm going to go there. You're going to see that I get to that place, and I'll see that he gets there. And then you'll see me back here, and I'll be back in my thing and go to bed. That's all I want. Oblivion." And all these things are like, shit. What is this, fucking Shakespeare? This is awesome.
Yeah, Orson Welles.
Orson.
But the episode, it's pretty cut and dry. There's not a lot of special things. The twist is kind of weak. But I didn't hate the episode. It wasn't a chore to get through. It felt too close to other episodes we've seen, and not enough like the episodes you want to see.
It was like an episode of Cheers where I felt good about it, but I didn't really like laugh like it when it wanted me to laugh or feel like emotional at the right times. It felt, because again, like that one breathtaking little scene, and then later when he comes back and kind of acts like a boss, because he was looking like out of his shit, and like when the guy's like, "Now you see here, tell me you're late," and all that stuff, and then he's like, and like panics and like leaves. I thought this was going to be about him like falling apart or whatever.
Yeah.
But then when he comes back, he's like carries himself differently. He's like, "I'm a fucking boss now. Oh, there's a script." Good one, God.
But
like, what is he
talking
about?
When he came back into the room, too, the director's demeanor was different. Like, the producer, and I'm like, were they in on this somehow? Are they magic?
Oh, maybe that's the reason? That's even worse. Oh, my God. Because
right? There was a clear difference.
I had the same thought where they were like, okay, is he done doing that thing? Because it didn't feel like, this prima donna has to go out and have a smoke and then come back and be like, okay, I'll do it now.
Yeah.
Like, ugh. You know, it had this feel of like, okay, yes, good. All right. Very weird. Maybe, so I was hoping that I had missed something and that you were going to be like, oh, you missed this obvious thing about the episode.
Yeah, if you missed it, I missed it too. But I feel like
it's possible,
there's probably some like thing like, and then he realized blah, blah, like written in the script that just didn't translate properly.
Something might be left out, or something might, because these were made so long ago that certain cultural things might be implied. I don't see how that's possible here, right?
No.
But there's certain stuff, right, in these episodes where it's like, oh, for like a woman to say that to her boss is a big deal, but we don't pick up on it now. Like certain things. But there's nothing like that here,
but,
right?
Yeah, this particular episode, I don't think, is screwing us in that way.
So are we thumbsing it down? What do we think about this?
I don't think. Do we usually give thumbs up on these?
Do we assign thumbs to this?
I didn't really, I could take or leave this episode. It wasn't nearly one of the worst ones, but it didn't
have the things that a Twilight Zone is supposed to have.
It didn't feel
right?
genuine enough. Like, it didn't feel like here's our new fresh concept to woo you this week. Like, I would have been like, oh, all right.
No, like, I really, like, Twilight Zone to me is like, oh, this guy doesn't age, and he's like, this is immortal guy.
Something.
Let's find the thing.
Or we have a box, or there's a curse, or, something.
Or like, aliens are doing this, or it was Earth all along, or it was not Earth all along. Like, some weird moment where you go, holy shit, or whatever. And we didn't really, unless that one moment that I like was that, but it wasn't a mind fuck, it wasn't a twist. It was just like, what the fuck's going on here? And the answer to what's going on here, not very satisfying.
Yeah. All right, guys. So that's our thoughts on this episode of Twilight Zone. If you have thoughts, let us know in those comments below. Don't die in a fire, and we'll see you next time.
Hello, internets. I just love watching JustDaggers. If you enjoyed this video as much as I have, click that subscribe button. Peace out, homies. I gotta go.